So one of the inspirations for me making this film was the fact that my partner's adopted. He's always known that he can just go and find out information about his birth parents fairly easily whenever he wants to. And I just couldn't understand how donor-conceived people were not in the same situation and how they were not able to find out the names or the identifying information of their biological parent.
For me, it's incredible to think of the number of people, and the estimates are around, you know, 40,000 or 50,000 people out there who don't know they're donor conceived. I mean, it's unfortunate that a lot of this has come back onto the parents rather than, you know, the doctors or the clinics, etc. I mean, it's the parents who are wrestling with this information or this secret. And I really feel for them. I feel that what a terrible secret to have to hold and to withhold from your child.
Understandably, it was incredibly difficult to find any parents who were really willing to share their point of view, because they're still carrying a lot of that grief and anxiety from that time. So we were incredibly lucky and privileged to have Simon, Miff's dad, speak to us. I thought that was a very, very brave thing to do, and I hope that it helps other parents to also be able to talk about these issues with their kids and with other people.
One of the situations that really stood out to me as, you know, showing what a conundrum that, you know, people are in around anonymous donations was when Jeff went to Monash IVF to find out more information about his donor, and the council was aware of who the donor was in terms of a name, but she's not able to give that name to Jeff, who's sitting in front of her, until that man consents. I mean, that just crystallises for me how not enough thought went into what it meant to use anonymous sperm and egg donations and what wasn't considered were the rights of the children. And I think you have the right to know your genetic background. I mean, it's a human right to know that. So I think it's about time that that was honoured.
In other countries around the world, people still really believe that it's better for donor-conceived people to not know about their biological heritage and to not have the right to find out about their biological parent. I think it's going to take a long time for the changes to come. But one of the things that has always struck me was Ian Smith's comment in the film, where as a donor, he feels that the rights of the child are paramount. And that's how I feel, even though I understand that some donors will be in an incredibly difficult situation.
You know, you can still go to Greece and get an anonymous egg. You can still go to Spain and get an anonymous egg. I don't know, perhaps people think it's the best thing to do, but I think it's really good to be educated about these choices, because you're making decisions for your unborn child, and I think you have to think about what's in their best interest.